My firefighters did a complete search of their entire building, every single floor, every single room. To my knowledge, everyone was accounted for except for one member that worked for the bank. He is still unaccounted for. We have the sheriff's department send the mini drone down in the basement. He said there's nothing to see. The floor is collapsed in on itself. There's nothing to see. It's full of water. So honestly, we don't know if that person is down there or not. When we get clearance to go in the building, I mean, we will, but until then, I will not put one of my firefighters down there to do a search for any reason right now. As far as no firefighters got hurt, everybody, the six people that were transported are up at the hospital. Right now, to my knowledge, they're all in good condition. One person's intubated on a ventilator. I don't know who or he or she is. Like I said, all my firefighters are fine. We don't want to put anyone in that building because of the structural integrity of the building. We're not going to put anybody in that building. And Chuck Sastro can speak to the road closures, but International Towers, we're going to allow the people in that building to occupy that building. Now, the Doubletree, I'm not going to allow anybody to be inside that building because of the structural integrity of the building that exploded. We're not really sure, you know, how stable it is, so I'm not going to put anybody in the Doubletree. People in the National Towers can go back, but we're going to have the Chuckers folks speak to you about the road closures. But we're going to keep, we want that building completely void of any traffic, be it foot traffic or automobile traffic.
How concerned are you about that building?
Just
when
you first arrived at the scene.
One second. We're going to do it in order.
Okay.
And then we'll take questions after that. All right.
Thanks for killing
us. Chuck's going to talk.
And I'm sorry, your name, did you say your name and spell it? I'm so sorry, sir.
Barry Finley, BarryFinley. I'm the fire chief.
All right. Chuck Sasso's next.
Hi. Everyone, Charles Sasho, SHASHO. So right now, we have obviously a lot of roads throughout downtown, in and out of downtown block. For the time being, the roads that are going to stay closed are going to be Market Street and Wick Avenue, north and southbound, Federal Street from Phelps Street to Champion Street, Federal Street from Phelps Street to Walnut Street. Commerce Street, Walnut Street, and Boardman Street will stay open for traffic. As of right now, after conversations with the building owner, he is en route to the scene. The building owner will have to provide some type of structural assessment on the building as immediate safety, but for right now, we're erring on the side of caution and securing the site from any pedestrians and vehicular traffic. So just to please keep in mind, it's keep out of the blocked off area, keep out of the site. It is a danger. And then when we proceed further with a detailed structural assessment, we'll see where the building owner goes from here.
Do you know how old the building is?
Can you spell your name first? Can you spell it, please?
Yeah, I'll spell it again. It's Charles, common spelling, Sasho, S-H-A-S-H-O.
And what's your title?
Deputy Director of Public Works.
Can you talk about how old the building is and I guess what the potential impact, the ground floor, the basement, and then the floors above as a result of the explosion?
I don't know the exact age of the building. I'm guessing it's somewhere in the early 1900s, the teens maybe. Right now, we do see a couple of missing fascia beams at the grade level that are may or may not be compromising some of the columns. So until we're able to get in there and do a more detailed assessment, we won't be able to really make a full assessment.
Were there any concerns about the structural integrity of that building or any nearby buildings in the past? I mean, we know that Enbridge Gas representatives are there right now. Have they been called recently?
We don't have any record of any type of structural issues in the realty building itself. I do know that the building owner is going to have to get a detailed and you deal with their insurance company and so forth on. I'm not going to speak to that.
All right, question for the chief.
I'm just on the scene. Can you just tell us what happened today around 3 o'clock that you know so far? All the facts, please.
The only fact that really exists is there was an explosion. We're not sure what caused the explosion. We know Dominion's out here checking over their lines. We have no idea what caused the explosion. We know that there was an explosion and it did a lot of damage to the bottom of the building.
So 6 to 7 people were transported to the hospital?
Yes.
Are you surprised more people weren't injured?
Yes.
Can I do one at a time? We got a little time.
Again, Dominion is out here. They're doing assessment of all their equipment to find out if it was a gas leak. But as of right now, all I know for sure is that there was an explosion.
Chief, when I spoke to you a few minutes ago, you told me paramedics found when they arrived. That's the second what they
question.
Did.
You're monopolizing the question.
I'm sorry. Sorry about that.
Let everybody get a question. Let's go.
What'd you want? What did your firefighters and paramedics find to see when you arrived, and what exactly did they do?
They did what they were trained to do. They went in the building, got out everyone that they could get out. EMS stood by, and anyone that was hurt or injured got taken to the hospital by EMS. And my firefighters went floor by floor, room by room, elevator by elevator, space by space, clearing that building to ensure that no one else was in that building and no one else was hurt.
I spoke to you on the phone about an hour ago. You told me you were still searching for at least 2 missing people. What's the latest on those people?
We still haven't found them.
2 people or 1 person?
To my knowledge, there's 2 people, a man and a woman. We haven't found either one of them.
Both Chase employees.
I believe one of them was a Chase employee. The other woman, I don't know. And I know that those 2 were not transported to the hospital.
At this point, we don't know of any fatalities, though, right?
At this point, we don't know of any fatalities.
Chief, what are the injuries that you're hearing? I mean, what did these people suffer?
By the time I got on scene, the 7 people that went to the hospital had been transported. So I have no idea what the injuries are. And I did not call the hospital to find out of any injuries.
Do you know how many people were in the building?
No, ma'am, I do not.
And you said there's apartments above, right? How
yes.
many stories of apartments?
13 stories? 12?
12 stories.
The basement belongs to Chase?
To my knowledge,
the basement, the first floor, and then above that are just the apartments.
Apartments.
So this is, you have a building owner who owns the building.
Yeah.
Chase just has that.
Well, they
that
rent, one they floor. Rent
the
basement.
Space, mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
Any
confirm
other questions?
If there was more than 1 explosion?
I cannot confirm. I cannot confirm that.
Chief, at this point, it does not look suspicious. I mean, this looks like...
I have no idea.
Yeah, we don't want to call that.
We'll let those
who do that job make that call. At this time, we're taking what we have, and that's all we have.
People are worried about when they can get back inside. Is there...
What building?
The building that they live in, the International Towers building.
International Towers. I will be opening that building back up so that the residents can go in there. But anybody that was living in the building that exploded, that's not happening.
Will you be searching for those missing people all night?
We absolutely will.
Is there a Red Cross or somebody involved?
Red Cross is working at the Covelli Center with the residents of the International Tower, so they've come up. And one of the things I want to tell you guys that, you know, this community, everyone who came to help from all over this county, both counties, I want to reach out and take thank you from the citizens of Youngstown, Ohio. The chief and his staff, they did what they needed to do, but there were so many emergency staff from all over who said, I wanted to help. I got so many calls from all over, the governor, the senators, to say if they can help. So we're going to continue to give you what we have. I like to give you the facts. I don't want to make anything up. I'm just giving you what we have right now. So this is what we have right now. We may not have anything for the rest of the day, and if we do, we'll let you know.
There's a lot of construction going on right now. Is there any concern that maybe construction crews could have ruptured a line or anything like that? Are you looking into that?
You want me to speculate? I'm not going to do that. I have no idea. I don't do construction. I just know that right now we're worried about the life and the safety of this community first. We're going to start with that, then we'll figure out what happened.
So, Mayor, no idea how long this part of downtown will be shut down, right?
However long it takes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. However long it takes.
Are you absolutely sure this man and woman were in the building at the time of the explosion?
Not just absolutely.
Okay.
But we just know that when the chief do our safety checks, there's a process they use, and our prayers and hope is that they were not. So, thank you guys
thank
so much.
You.
Thank you.